Hey guys, and welcome back to BeardYGO. So today we've got an exciting opening, but before we get into that, let's get on with the giveaways for the 300 subscriber special video I did. You guys, we got over 2,000 views on that video, and I want to thank every single one of you who took the time to watch the video. So yeah, let's get into the spin. So winner number one for the Hero goodie set, the file, the deck box, as well as the file, winner number one, and we have got Anakin's. Congratulations. You can drop me a message in Discord so that we can get your prize to you. Then we'll remove Anakin's over here and we will spin for the second time, and let's see who gets to win this one. All right, there we go. Selma van den Jeffer, thank you very much. Drop me a message in Discord. We get your prizes to you as well. We're removing Selma and we are going off to the last one. And let's see who it lands on. There we go. Zeldia van Vieren, congratulations. You are the third and final winner of the Hero goodie bag, basically, is what you can call it. So yeah, drop me a message in Discord and we can get your prizes to you. Right, so let's get on to the actual opening, guys. Right, you guys, so here we are. We have got a case of the 2022 Megatons, and so I'm gonna be opening half a case on this video, and I will be giving away 6 tins to 6 lucky people. You guys, if you have kept up with the channel from the beginning, thank you so much. We've basically come full circle where I think it was my first video where I opened the 2021 Megatons and I did like a whole 8K speed run, you know. So this time just opening the 6 is going to be a little bit more up and personal. I can chat to you guys a little bit. And yeah, which should we start with? I think let's just go with the bottom half. So we will keep the bottom half basically for the opening. And yeah, there we go. That's a nice little tower. And these 6 are gonna go straight through to 6 lucky subscribers. So let's move this over. And let's get to opening the tins. Got our lucky pin over here. So there are a bunch of short prints and stuff which are pretty difficult to get. Like Konami even half printed some stuff, and that's another thing that you don't really see. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna open all of these tins just to save time. But yeah, the half printing is a little bit of an issue. Konami, I hope that you guys actually fix that a little bit, you know. As players, you don't want to open a lot of product and be disappointed because you cannot get certain cards. It's pretty difficult, you know. I know it's amazing business strategy, but yeah, you gotta look out for the players sometimes. Your customer is very important. Right, so the Megatons, obviously the reprint set of the year, and I would say that the reprints are pretty cool. There's some really, really nice Egyptian god support. I would say that this year's, you know, new cards, which is the Egyptian god stuff, was actually better than last year's Blue Eyes and Dark Magician support, if I must say so myself. So that's really awesome. The nice thing is that we also have different rarity, well, alternate art basically of Blue Eyes, Red Eyes, as well as Dark Magician Girl. And if I'm correct at saying that those artworks will basically never be done again. So yeah, very, very cool, very nice for the collectors. And then we obviously have some really nice staples in here as well, like Prosperity, Forbidden Droplet, Lightning Storm. We've got Dragoon, Crossout Designator, DPE, you know, all of the good stuff. And yeah, so there we go. We've got our packs and let's get to opening pack number one. Right. Let's drop this down and let's get the focus in. Alright, so Bujin Candescence, Om Dragon level 5, Fabled Maricozia, Psychic Eraser Laser, Om Dragon Thunder level 3, Fabled Android. And our first super, we got Book of Lunar Eclipse, very, very nice card. We got the Virtual Gate. Is one new. Then we have our first Ultra Danger Disturbance Disorder. And we've got a Dark Ruler No More. Another really cool thing about Dark Ruler No More in this set is that you actually get a copy which doesn't have the E. You know, if I can get that up there. You know, we've got the Dark Ruler No More. However, there's a misprint in this set where it is Dark Ruler No Morph, so the E is an F, which is really cool. And moving on to our secret rare, we've got Underworld Goddess of the Closed World, another wonderful, wonderful reprint. Okay, so we will separate secrets, ultras, and supers, and then we've got our rare Fluanderies and the Unexplored Winds. Magikey Mech Mortar, Trickstar Festival, Sunvine Sewing, Magikey Dragon, Androbeam, B-Trooper Scale Bomber, and we've got the Gunken Su-Ship, Ikura Class Dreadnought. Okay, so we are obviously just going to skip through all of the bulk basically. I will just go through them and we will go straight on to the foils and the rare. We got Goki Finishing Move, we've got Fluanderies and Empen, our Ultra we've got Heritage of the Light, as well as AI Meet You, and we've got Destiny Hero Destroyer, Phoenix Enforcer right here, awesome, awesome, and Power of Metal Foes Fusion for our rare. Moving on to the rest of the commons, as you can see, we've got some very nice reprints. I like this set quite a lot because you've got a lot of things that you can basically just you know, get easier access of. That's the whole reason for the tins, you know. Right, we've got Ice Jade Tremora. This was a secret. We've got a downgrade over here. Ooh, Heritage of Light should be there. Right, Tremora, Ghost Reaper and Winter Cherries. This is also a very nice set for all of the hand traps. You know, you've got cherries, you've got the moonlit, you've also got the spooky ogre, as well as Ash and Bell. So really, really nice set encompassing all of the ghost sisters. Then we got Stardust Trail as an ultra rare, on Dragon Thunder level 10. And Om Dragon Thunder level 7. Well, would you look at that? Alright, so that's our secret Stardust Illumination for our rare. And the rest of the commons. The nice thing about this set is like Fluanderies is very easily accessible right now. People can play the Despia stuff much easily as well. Much more easily, sorry. And B-Troopers as well. You know, people were trying to pick up B-Troopers, you can basically just pick everything up for so cheap right now, which is just really amazing. Okay, so looks like we have got a miscut Magical Cylinders. If you see over there, there is like almost no border. And it looks like we've got a ghost mourner as well, which is also a miscut, which is very interesting. Right, back to normal quality control. We've got Threshold Borg. We have DDD Super Sight, Zero King Maxwell, and our secret is ZS Ascended Sage for all you Utopia lovers out there. An Archfiend Staff of Despair as our rare. Right, moving on to the next pack. Right, so we got all of these little commons over here. And again, another miscut. Like, wow, okay, very interesting. Saw Avalon Daphne and Binary Blader. Is it just the supers? It looks like it, eh? Which is really, really interesting. Alright, so we got Dimension Shifter as another ultra rare. Very nice. We've got Reinforcements of the Army's Troops. And our secret rare, we've got Greater Polymerization. Really, really nice. Prismatic secret rares just look so much better than the regular ones, in my opinion. Let me know what you think of the prismatic secrets versus your normal secret rares. Do you like it or don't you like it? Which one's better? Right, we are actually hoping, like, you know, the only card I'm really hoping for in this set, to be honest, from a collector's point of view, is the Dark Magician Girl. I would really like to get the Dark Magician Girl. Right, so we got another miscut Ghost Sister and Spooky Dogwood. We've got a Machina Ruin Force, another miscut as well. And it seems to just be the supers there, which is really, really interesting. We've got Starter Synchron as an ultra. Alva and the Essence of Vanity, very nice upgrade. I think this came in a common, if I'm not mistaken, and now we've got a very nice ultra rare that we can flex with. And our secret rare is Link into the Brains. This card has seen quite a bit of movement on the market, where, you know, it's just such an easy way to get your plays off, you know, especially like, I think it was Magical Muskets that really, really used this card quite a bit. We got Judge of the Ice Barrier as our rare. Okay, we are done with two tins, so let's get on to our third tin. And we have got all of our little commons here, and we're back to normal quality control, basically. Still a little off center, but we've got Slower Swallow as our super. We've got ZW Pegasus Twin Saber. And we've got the Revived Sky God. You guys, this card is insane. I don't know if you can see that, but let's get a close-up there of the effect. We've got the activation of this card or its effects cannot be negated, nor can its effects be negated. Special summon one Slife of the Sky Dragon from your grave. Then each player draws until they have 6 cards in their hand. You can banish this card from your grave, place one Monster Reborn from your deck or grave on top of your deck, and then if a Divine Beast Monster is in your grave, draw one card. You can basically set this up to like draw 7 cards, which is just really, really insane. I really like this card. Alright, so moving on, we've got Gaia Armor Dragon Shell. This was a common, if I'm not mistaken. I really like that it's an ultra right now. It's a really, really cool little card, and I think it'll see play in the future. And our secret rare, we have got Dramaturge of Despia, a very nice rarity upgrade to Prismatic Secret from ultra rare. Then we've got Fluanderies and Eaglin, really cool. And the rest of our commons. Right, moving on to pack number 2 of 10-3. We have got all our little commons, and we've got the Machina Ruin Force once again. We've got Ghost Sister and Spooky Dogwood. Funny enough, this card is actually seeing quite a bit of play now because of the time rules, so people are starting to use this against combo decks so they can just gain life and win, basically. So So yeah, really cool card. Then we've got Dogmatica Genesis as an ultra rare. We've also got Breath of Acclamation, which is an ultra rare. The nice thing about this tins as well, a lot of people think that this is just filler and all that, but I really like that they basically added all of the ritual spells for the elements. So this is for a wind one, and then you got the dark, you got the light, you've got the earth, you got, I think, the water as well. I'm not sure about fire. Can't remember about fire. But yeah, it's really, really cool. I like that they just gave all of these a little rarity upgrade and dropped them into the tins. And our secret rare. Oh, there we go. We have got the Blue Eyes White Dragon. Wow, this card is insane, guys. This thing looks so nice. Let's get a wonderful little close-up on that. Yeah, look at that. That is just beautiful. I really like this artwork. I don't know. Let me know. Do you think it's ugly? Like, it's got such a big head, man. It's almost competing with Ash Blossom. But, you know, it's really cool. I don't know. I dig it. I really like it. Okay, so we've got a Blue Eyes. We'll just place this bad boy over there. And we got Mahavelo Light of the Heavens as a rare. And then finishing up with the rest of those commons. Last pack of turn number 3. And we are halfway there. Right, so we've got Live Twin Lila Treat. We've also got Beast King Unleashed. We've got Warrock Skylar. Let me just adjust that here. There we go, Warrock Skylar. We've got the True Sun God. So this is another one of those promos, those Egyptian god supports, you know. So we've got the True Sun God continuous spell. When this card is activated, add one the Winged Dragon of Ra or one card that mentions it from your deck to your hand, except the True Sun God. Monsters except the Winged Dragon of Ra cannot attack the turn they are special summoned. Once per turn during a main phase, you can send this card from the field or one the Winged Dragon of Ra Immortal Phoenix from your deck to the grave, then send one the Winged Dragon of Ra from your monster zone to the grave. So that would trigger Immortal Phoenix, if I'm not mistaken. And also, you know, you could actually just use this as a mini floodgate type of thing so that you can prevent your opponent from attacking you. So they'll have to get rid of this in order to attack you, which could lead them to expending extra resources. Really, really cool. Alright. Ready Fusion as our secret rare. Really, really nice card. I really like the artwork on this card. It's been pretty cool. You know, you got Kozaki over there in the middle. I don't know if you guys can see that. Kozaki. It's almost like it's like magical scientist, actually, if I'm not mistaken. I think it's the same character though. But yeah, really, really cool. We got Chronomaly Bimana getting a downgrade to rare from ultra rare. Really nice, really cool card. Right, guys, that is it for the first 3 tins. Let's speed through the last 3. Right, so we've got Chapchick Scolaria, Sunvine Crossbreed, Dogmatica Genesis, Gaia Armor Jagged Cell, and we've got Small World, another awesome reprint. Very nice. We've got Laundry Trap as our rare, and the rest of the commons. So, guys, let me know if you want to win one of the tins, what card you are looking for out of the tins. You know, what's the card you are looking for? The one and only, you know.
Blue Eyes!
I'm joking. Whatever. Right, we got Paleozoic Cambro Raster. We got Masquerade the Blazing Dragon. Very nice, so people can get it. We got Dimension Shifter again. Are we going to get a playset out of this?
We've got Alva and the Essence of Vanity, and our secret is Ghost Spell and Haunted Mansion. There we go, very nice. I like this. Awesome. Ultimate Flagship Ursatron as our rare. Right, next pack. We've got Book of Lunar Eclipse as our super. Virtual Gates Wanyu. We've got Danger Disturbance. Is this like a pack that is... I don't know, is this the same as our first pack? Dark Ruler No More. It seems to look like it. Seems to look like it. What was our first secret? Underworld Goddess? Is that what we're gonna get? Let's see. Oh no, it's Drytron Mu Beta Fafnir. Alright, very nice for Drytron players. We got Bee Trooper Scout Buggy as our rare. Next pack. We got Fluandreason and Empin. Scream of the Branded. The Breaking Ruin card. So this is another one of the god support. So the activation of this card and or its effects cannot be negated, nor can its effects be negated. Special summon one Obelisk the Tormentor from your hand or grave, and if you do, it's unaffected by your opponent's card effects this turn. If you tribute two or more monsters you control at the same time to activate your card or effect while you control Obelisk the Tormentor, you can banish this card from your grave. Banish all monsters your opponent controls. All monsters in your opponent's grave, imagine. And if you do, inflict 500 damage to your opponent for each. This is a card that you can actually OTK with. You know, it's really, really cool. I really like it. We've got Breath of Acclamation. And our secret rare is Armed Dragon Thunder level 7. Magic Ace Spirit, Bird Part 2 as our rare. Right, next up on Dragon Ball Yu-Gi-Oh, we got Fluandreese and Stree. We've got Danmariatic Mister, Dragon Lord Terran. I like that this has gotten a rarity upgrade. We've got DD Assault Carrier, and our secret rare is Evil Twins Trouble Sunny. Very nice, Lavalval X-Lord as our rare. Next one, we've got Goki Finishing Move as our super, Radiant Voirescence, Stardust Synchron, Contract with the Abyss, this is to summon a dark, Ritual, and we have got our Ruddy Rose Dragon as our secret rare. Very, very nice. I really like this. Let's increase that there we go. Ruddy Rose, nice. And we got Riliona the Wondrous Magistus Witch Wardrobe as our rare. Right guys, we've got one pin left. Let's see, left side first. We have got White Knight of Dogmatica, Screams of the Branded, The Breaking Ruin God, Warrock Skylar, and our secret, Evil Twins Trouble Sunny. Fluandreese and Eaglin again. Left, and we will finish, right, and then we'll finish off with the middle pack. Right, Goki Finishing Move, Sun Avalon Daphne, Scrap Raptor, that's a nice one, Dark Infant Adagnesta. Now our secret rare is Underworld Goddess of the Closed World once again. Synchro Transmission for our rare. And last pack guys, last pack, are we going to finish strong? Let's hope, let's hope, let's hope. Let's see. We've got High ritual art. Trap tricks, vesiculo. Contract with the abyss. AI meet you. And our secret ray is Lord of the Heavenly Prison. Alright, very, very cool. Awesome. Guys, that means, from what I've seen, is that one of you who is going to get the one of you who's gonna be winning one of the tins is going to most likely be pulling a pot of prosperity. I've seen two, one, like, yeah, you're either getting one or maybe even two in a case. So there's either one or two in here. And I've heard from one of my friends is that, you know, there's actually a possibility to even have four in a case. Highly unlikely since I've just opened half of it, but hey, maybe I just opened bad so you guys can open good. Right, guys, thank you so much for checking this out. And I just want to say thank you so much to SOLARPOP and UNPLUG Yourself for sponsoring this video and sponsoring the products, guys. They've provided us with a case so that we can get as many tins out to you guys as possible and see how deep we can get into the tins and what we can pull. And I am very happy with these blue eyes, white dragon. Really cool. I'm definitely going to be framing it. And yeah, that is it. So once again, if you guys want to win one of the tins, then just drop a comment down below. Make sure you're subbed. Make sure you like the video, share the video, turn on notifications, do all those things. Drop a comment and say which card you would like to have from the tins. What's the most sought after card for you to collect from the tins? Once again, thank you, SOLARPOP, and UNPLUG Yourself. And yeah, guys, just make sure that, you know, all of these prizes are available to South Africans only residing in South Africa. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Cheers.